College football spells excitement, color, pageantry, the collegiate spirit at its enthusiastic best. Football Western Athletic Conference style possesses all these qualities and one more. Wide open, full throttle, gridiron action. This is Keith Jackson with a story of another totally wild WAC season. 1973, a year where the quarterbacks dominated. The WAC was unsurpassed by any other conference in yardage-producing efforts. Exciting offensive football at its best. The conference championship race and the accompanying Fiesta Bowl berth not decided until the final game of the season. But the story of Western Athletic Conference football 1973 was the superb individual effort emanating from each of the eight WAC schools. Welcome to Football Western Style, brought to you by Frontier Airlines. Jet Frontier, you really get a better deal.
Frontier's pleased to bring you the football highlights of the Western Athletic Conference and to show you some of the places we touched down in over 100 cities and 16 states. This is our home field from the Great Arch in the east to the excitement capital of the world, the big sky country in the north, to the sizzling sun country in the south. Come explore this great country with Frontier's money-saving package plan. Take off, stretch out, and enjoy first-class legroom, plus twin seat comfort at coach prices on every Frontier jet. Next vacation, ask your professional travel agent about Frontier. You'll see, you really get a better deal.
Western Athletic Conference quarterbacks dominated the collegiate football scene in 1973. Seven of the eight were among the top 24 nationally in total offense, led by a new face at Brigham Young University. BYU coach Lavelle Edwards tutored the nation's most prolific passing combination, junior quarterback Gary Scheide and sophomore receiver Jay Miller. Scheide had thrown but one pass until the fourth quarter of game three, but that one was for a touchdown. The junior college transfer then awoke the slumbering Cougar offense with an eight-game display, which put him number two in national passing statistics. His favorite target, the speedy Miller, caught an even 100 passes to rank as the top receiver in the country. Scheide was good at improvisation, taking advantage of opportunities. Scheide chopped up the BYU and WAC record books, breaking nine individual marks. Miller also set nine records and went Scheide one better when he broke an NCAA record with 22 receptions in one game. Passing keyed the renaissance at Colorado State University, where new coach Sark Arslanian turned the Ram program around.
We at Colorado State University are just in a great building program at this stage of the game. We have gone to a definite pro offense and a pro defense. We had to throw the ball a great many times this year. In fact, we ended up seventh in the nation in pass offense, and our quarterback, Jan Stuby, ended up 10th in the nation. And of course, this is built around some great receivers that we have and hope to continue to get in the future.
Stuby's favorite receivers were number 13, Willie Miller, and number 88, Jim Kennedy. Stuby played but one varsity season because of injury problems, but his baseball throwing style put the Rams back on the winning track. Jan set six school passing records with his unorthodox delivery. Willie Miller, a 26-year-old Vietnam veteran, already owns all Colorado State receiving records and still has a senior season to go. He's fairly agile for an old man. You don't find too many 26-year-old collegiate receivers, much less one the caliber of the speedy Willie Miller. At Texas El Paso, the Miners have stressed aerial warfare for many seasons. And 1973 was no different, with Frank Duncan throwing and Don Willis catching. Continuing the UTEP tradition of super pass receivers was Lonnie Crittenden. He specialized in the sensational catch. At Utah, Coach Bill Meeks stressed wide-open offense. This season, Don Van Golder guided the up-and-down Utes to some memorable moments against Texas Tech, Oregon, and Arizona State. His favorite target, swift Steve Odom. Odom, a hard man to contain, one of the most entertaining football stars to perform for Frontierland fans. Another clutch receiver was number 45, Willie Armstead, and he'll be back in 1974. Van Golder departed Utah with 13 records, including the career total offense mark. Don ranked 10th in total offense in the nation in 1973. At the University of New Mexico, Coach Rudy Feldman opened up the wishbone and installed quarterback Don Woods, who proved you can pass off the wishbone. But Woods was more noted for his running ability. He rushed for more yards than any other quarterback in the country in 1973. Watch what he does with a broken play.
The 1973 Wyoming Cowboys were a young football team with only 8 seniors, led by senior quarterback Steve Cockerham, who set about 22 school records. We feel real good about the 1974 year with a good freshman team and good young players. We feel as though we'll be real competitive in the conference next season.
Cockerham's favorite receiver was junior Archie Gray. He should leave Wyoming as the all-time receiver, and here are several reasons why he already owns 6 Cowboy records. Cockrum was a masterful runner. He set 7 records, including one for career total yardage. Arizona's Bruce Hill took his team to a tie for the conference title. Only a sophomore, Hill showed he is a complete football player. He was named Rookie of the Year in the Western Athletic Conference.
We started out with a rather young team this year. We came along quite fast in the early part of the season and won several big games in the Western Athletic Conference and a couple of non-league opponents, and were able to tie for the championship in our first year.
Bruce Hill was the master at running the option. As easy as 1, 2, 3. Hill's favorite receivers were number 89, Mark Neal, and number 18, sophomore, T. Bell. Danny White was the Arizona State quarterback for 32 games, the starter in every one of them. The Sun Devils won 28 of them. He guided the potent ASU offense to over 500 yards a game over the past 2 years and won or shared in the WAC crown each of his three varsity seasons. Toss in three straight Fiesta Bowl wins and you have a superb career. White concluded 1973 by being named the Western Athletic Conference Player of the Year. Wingback Morris Owens, number 24, ran the deep pattern as well as anyone. He set one national record in 1973 and comes back for an encore in 74. So much for the fireworks. The quarterbacks and receivers had their day in 1973. So did a fine fleet of strong running backs, three of whom were ranked in the top 25 ground gainers in the country. No other conference could make that boast. Arizona State's Woody Green was acclaimed as the most complete running back in the country. He closed out a fabulous career as the fourth leading rusher in college football history. The galloping style of ASU's Ben Malone became familiar to WAC fans. Green and Malone accounted for over 2,400 yards rushing in 1973. Bow-legged Benny was a tough man to tackle. Watch this one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Seven attempts before they finally bring him down. Arizona boasted a fine 1-2-3 punch led by Jim Upchurch, the country's 16th ranked ground gainer. Watch this individual effort in slow motion. The speed machine at Arizona was number two, Willie Hamilton, fine open field runner. Hamilton consistently terrified defenses with this kind of effort. Both Upchurch and Hamilton returned for 1974. Utah likes Ike. Ike Spencer, number 22. The junior halfback is destined to leave Utah as the top running back in that school's history. Wyoming has another underclassman who returns in 1974, Charlie Shaw. The Cowboy speedster broke one school record by turning the corners on the option and running tough up the middle. Brigham Young Steve Stratton was a punishing blocker, a hard-nosed runner, and an academic All-American. The sophomores, in this case Colorado State's Kim Jones, were bigger than the seniors and harder to bring down. Jones set a single game Ram rushing record in his first varsity season. At 6'4", 230 pounds, he is a tough hombre to corral. Another man to watch in 1974 is Texas El Paso's Don Willis, the fourth ranking running back in the Western Athletic Conference. He knows where that goal line is. When New Mexico opened up the wishbone offense, junior Ben Turner took full advantage of it. But the wishbone still had its workhorse, Rich Diller, number 35. He was the chief Lobo power runner. Even though WAC runners covered over 10 miles of terrain and the passers threw for nine more, the defense had its moments. Utah tackle Ron Rideout led the WAC defenders and was named Player of the Year. Let's take a quick look at other Western Athletic Conference defensive stars. LaFreddie Coleman, number 41 from Texas El Paso. Wyoming linebacker Frank Erzinger, number 83. New Mexico's Greg Jones, Randy Rich, and Dave Tolliver. Colorado State's Lauren Malkin. Arizona State's Sam Johnson. And the WAC's top pass interceptor, BYU's Mike Russell. All-America performance is next, but now a word from Frontier Airlines, the only airline serving all eight Western Athletic Conference cities.
Frontier wants your legs to feel great. That's why every Frontier jet has first-class leg room for everyone. When your legs feel good, you can jump and cheer. Tee off and chase that little white ball. Splash around the pool. Dance till all hours at your favorite spot. And get up for skiing. Wherever you fly in our home field, to Denver, St. Louis, Kansas City, Lincoln, Omaha, Dallas, Albuquerque, Salt Lake, Phoenix, or Tucson, you fly in comfort. And you get first-class legroom at coach prices. For reservations and information, call your professional travel agent. Then Jet Frontier. You really get a better deal.
Woody Green heads the list of 1973 WAC All-America First Team picks. His slashing style of running and breakaway speed netted him berths on four first teams and two second teams. Woody gained 3,700 yards in his Arizona State career. Danny White concluded a sensational year at Arizona State, breaking seven NCAA, 14 WAC, and 22 school records. He was the All-American quarterback on three squads and the runner-up on two others. Utah's Steve Odom was something else. As a kick return specialist, The Football Writers Association named him to their All-America team. Odom concluded his career with 5 NCAA kick return records, plus all of the WAC and Utah marks available to him. It was truly a record-setting Western Athletic Conference season. Now let's reflect on the conference race. Snow greeted the Sun Country boys from Arizona State as Coach Frank Kush's Sun Devils and Bill Meek's Utes dueled at Salt Lake City. The game was one of turnovers for Arizona State. 10 of them, to be exact. Opportunistic Don Van Galder took Utah to a 30-3 lead midway in the second quarter. Steve Odom chipped in with a touchdown reception and a long punt return. It was not the Devil's day. Van Galter scores here on a broken play. The Devils came roaring back on this white to green pass. Malone scores, but Utah prevails 36-31 to hand Arizona State its only loss in 1973. The resurgent Arizona Wildcats showed up at Brigham Young needing a win to ensure a share of the conference title. On 3rd and 10 with BYU defensing the option, Willie Hamilton broke through the middle en route to an 80-yard scoring sprint, and Arizona went ahead 7-0. Brigham Young tied the game, but Leon Lawrence then picked off a pass, and the Wildcats were ahead to stay 14-7. A great defensive effort by linebacker Ransom Terrell held the Cougars to 1 touchdown. Mike Dawson makes a stop. Leon Lawrence comes up quick from his safety spot to knock down a play. Jim Upchurch followed Hamilton's lead and put the game out of reach with this quick burst, again for 80 yards. And the WAC Coach of the Year, Jim Young, gets a free ride off the field. The big one had even more meaning in 1973 for ASU's Frank Kush. His Devils needed a win over rival Arizona to preserve a WAC championship string, which was to reach 5, and to gain a 3rd straight Fiesta Bowl berth. The coach's son, freshman kicker Danny Kush, gives ASU a 10-point lead on a 24-yard field goal. But Arizona fought back as Bruce Hill finds Mark Neal for 39 yards. Jim Upchurch, with the option pitch, roars into the end zone, and the Wildcats cut the margin to 10-6. The Devils scored again, but Hill hits T-Bell to set up a Wildcat touchdown. ASU now leads 16-13. Danny White hits Morris Owens on a 14-yard scoring pass, and Arizona State jumps to a 22-14 lead. Bruce Hill tries a fancy double reverse pass to Willie Hamilton, and ASU's lead is again cut to 22-19. But the White-Owens combination continues to score, this time for 58 yards and White's 4th touchdown pass of the first half. Woody Green's 11-yard run puts the Devils in command, and Arizona State off and running to a 55-19 victory, a spot in the Fiesta Bowl, and a share of the WAC crown with Arizona's surprising Wildcats. A brilliant desert sunset begins Fiesta Bowl 3. Western Athletic Conference co-champion Arizona State against the nation's most improved team, the University of Pittsburgh. Action begins on a sour note as ASU loses a fumble at its own 12-yard line on the game's first play. Pittsburgh freshman All-America halfback Tony Dorsett takes two plays to put the Panthers out in front. But Danny White gets ASU even in a hurry, hitting Greg Hudson to set up a touchdown. Woody Green takes it in. The game's most valuable defender, Mike Haynes, halts a pit drive with this interception. Late in the third quarter, White breaks a tie by eluding two Panthers and finding Hudson all alone in the end zone. Hudson named the outstanding offensive player. And Woody Green puts the game out of reach on this scoring jaunt. Wingback Morris Owen sets up the last score of the game. And Woody Green gets his final touchdown as a Sun Devil. As Greg Hudson, number 84, and Mike Haynes, number 40, receive their Fiesta Bowl awards from Bowl President George Taylor, let's wrap up the WAC season. In 1973, five of the eight WAC teams improved their one-loss records over those of 1972. One team stayed even. Wyoming quarterback Steve Cockrum received an NCAA postgraduate scholarship to continue his studies. And four WAC Gritters were named Academic All-Americans. They were Wyoming tackle Mike LaPiccolo, BYU fullback Steve Stratton, and halfback Dan Taylor, plus Utah flanker Steve Odom. The action, enjoyable, exciting, the rewards plentiful for the Western Athletic Conference in football in 1973. Football Western style has been brought to you by Frontier Airlines. Jet Frontier, you really get a better deal.